EmpiringSeniors.com. You can watch it on your computer at home.
Empowering Seniors, Friday, October the 2nd, cooking with Chef Henry and Old Troy. See you there.
Well, you've caught Hail Marys in your life.
Absolutely.
A lot of seniors out there, I'm sure they've caught Hail Marys in their lives along the way to being where they are right now.
My favorite celebrity interview was Bob Hope, but then I interviewed Bob so many times.
See you on October 2nd, and we'll suck it to you.
Hi, I'm Neil Sperry. I'd like to invite you to a very special virtual event, Empowering Seniors 2020.
On your laptop, on an iPad, it's a virtual event, October 2nd.
Welcome all. Great to see you. We're delighted to be here on this Friday, sharing a special day with a lot of empowering seniors.
Hi, I'm Scott Murray, along with my good friend, Tarrant County Commissioner Gary Fickus, who created this magnificent event entitled Empowering Seniors. This, by the way, is the 12th annual event.
Scott, this has become the event that so many seniors, caregivers, and baby boomers mark on their calendars months ahead. I mean months. Once this pandemic hit, we started receiving calls in late March and early October asking us to please have Empowering Seniors.
Well, it sounds like good stuff, Gary. And stick around for details. As our seminars, we're going to be talking to the doctor panel. That's right. Ask for the doctor panel, door prizes, bingo, and our expo exhibit hall. But before we get into the event itself, we have some good friends who have joined us. They've been around for a long, long time, at least the last few years. And I start with the Dallas Cowboy cheerleaders, the alumni from, yes, what decade? The 1970s. And they have created a special cheer for Empowering Seniors.
Hello, Empowering Seniors. We are so sorry we couldn't be with you today in person, but we are with you in spirit, and we hope to see you soon. Take it away, Beth.
We are the seniors, we are the seniors, the mighty, mighty seniors, the mighty, mighty seniors. Everywhere we go, everywhere we go, people want to know.
As you can see, they are one of the highlights of our event because they bring excitement, and since they're all seniors, they show that seniors can stay really active.
That's for sure, Gary. Let's talk a little something about that, okay? Now, for all these years, Empowering Seniors has been known for in-person experiences with the hospitals, Ask the Doctor panels, health screenings, workshops, bingo, door prizes, free food, and so much more.
And some of that's changed, Scott. Being a virtual event, we are having virtual on your computer, tablet, or smartphone experiences. But our participants have been, and still are, sending in questions for our two Ask the Doctor panels, and still learn from our medical workshops and from over a dozen senior-focused workshops. And while we don't have free food here, I hear you have some good news for our viewers. And one more thing, there are over 1,000 people watching online at this very minute. And with this being online, we're hearing from people all over. Look over here to the right side of your page and you'll see what we call the question box. You can leave comments or ask questions and we'll get right back to you. And please let us know where you're watching from. And we are serious about our technology. The only places you need to go is right here, www.empoweringseniors.com. In addition to being online with our normal web address, we're also sending our broadcast via Facebook Live. We're very thankful for Facebook being one of our loyal sponsors.
All right, and we're going to be talking about sponsors in a moment, but let's remember that Care and Care Insurance is once again our presenting sponsor. For many years, we can always count on them, and we really appreciate their continued support. And of course, our local hospitals are all back because they want to reach out to all of our seniors. Thanks to each and every one of you.
And we've reached out to our restaurant friends from these past years, and you'll find them listed on our restaurant pages. Please support them because each of them have been so helpful to our seniors in years past.
Well, that's a great idea, Gary. I tell you what, we do need, there's no question about it, to support all of our restaurants, especially during these trying times. Let's take a moment right now and talk a little something about how you have made today far bigger and certainly much more exciting than ever before, such as our Ask the Doctor panels. We have two of them coming up, and you can use our question feature to submit your questions. Look right here. That's the screen behind me over here. And type in your questions, and we can't guarantee enough that you're going to get every question asked. But we're going to try and do our very best, that's for sure.
For over 1,000 of you who registered early, you received a copy of this program in your mail at home. It has all the details from today's event, including the names of all of our sponsors.
Now, Commissioner, let me ask you this. You and your team have done so much great work over and over and over to put this event together. I mean, you didn't start yesterday. You've been doing this for years and years. So the easy thing to do would have been to cancel this year. I mean, you know what we've all had to endure, but you've jumped right in there and gone through so many hoops, as a basketball player would say, to bring this event together. So my congratulations to you and your team.
Well, Scott, it's been a wholly different kind of project along the way, and it's been worth it, as we've heard from our seniors. One of our most enjoyable parts has been how we've brought in one celebrity each year. Folks like Bobby Wygant, Neil Sperry, and your friends Jim Sundberg from the Texas Rangers, and Bob Lilly and Randy White from the Dallas Cowboys. You've helped us a lot of these times with your excellent connections, and we really thank you.
Well, I tell you what, how could you ever top some of those names? You talk about Randy White, you talk about Bob Lilly. Hall of Famers. I mean, it doesn't get any better than that, Gary.
Well, this year we've brought not one or two, not four or five, but eight folks you'll love to hear from.
I love it. That's great. And sock it to you, as they say, we will indeed, with Empowering Seniors 2020, the virtual edition, make it happen as we continue on. So stay tuned, my friends.
Scott, let's not go any further without thanking our friends at Care and Care Insurance. This is our fifth year for them to join us as a presenting sponsor. I want to thank our good buddy, Troy Dungan, the iconic weatherman and Care and Care member, along with the Care and Care team, Tana, Scott, Kelly, and the whole gang. Thank all of y'all for your support, not only of Empowering Seniors, but of senior activities throughout Texas, including Senior Synergy from Tarrant County Judge Whitley's office.
And also coming up, as you well know, we're going to be visiting with Troy in a few minutes. But right now, let's show you how Empowering Seniors will continue to work. Look at the monitor beside us, and this is what your computer or phone screen should look like. Take a look at it. Gary and I are live right now on this Friday. And in just a little while, you'll be able to press a button and go to all kinds of places. It's really kind of cool. Now, in the past 3 days, over 500 early registrants drove by the Northeast Courthouse in Hearst to pick up their goodie bags. And we also mailed out over 1,000 copies of this printed program. Pretty good stuff, huh? And if you didn't get one, all you've got to do is come to our office. It's 645 Grapevine Highway in Hearst on Monday or Tuesday of next week.
First, let's talk about our Ask the Doctor panels starting at noon. You'll be able to submit questions to this address right here with our question feature. Now, we can't guarantee you that we're going to get around to every question, but we'll do a bunch of them. Send in your questions right now.
Sounds like a deal. And you know what? Each afternoon, I certainly look forward to our friend David Finfrock. That's a fellow I've known for about 40 years. Hard to believe. He gives us the weather forecast for that night and the next few days. Here's an excerpt now from David Finfrock, chief meteorologist from KXAS NBC5, presented by United Healthcare.
This looks like it's going to be a great day. I am forecasting a severe fun warning. So if you don't want to have a good time, you need to leave the program now because we've got all kinds of wonderful guests lined up who are going to be speaking and telling great stories and hopefully helping you negotiate those senior years. We're trying to do the same. Scott, I'm thinking back to when we used to work together every night. And what you may not know is after you went home, when we had some real winter storm warnings and I was concerned about roads icing up and, the worst thing that could happen would be if we had snow or ice overnight and the morning meteorologist wouldn't be able to make it in. That was my big fear. And so there were times when I spent the night at the station. I would take a sleeping bag and a pillow and a change of clothes. And here's the part you may not know. I would sneak into the sports office, which was dark. I couldn't go to the newsroom. That's busy all night. But in sports, it was quiet after midnight, and I could lay down. I used to lie down under your desk, Scott, and get a good night's snooze there, just to make sure I was ready if they needed me in the morning. But generally, the morning meteorologist was able to make it in without any issues. Now, I'm not the only weathercaster who is going to be presenting today. A little later, I think you're going to be hearing from Troy Dungan. And Troy, of course, a friend and a longtime competitor. What he may not realize, though, is that back when I was growing up in Houston, Troy was one of the weathercasters on KTRK, Channel 13, there in Houston. And I recall vividly the night he left to move, I believe it was up to Detroit he was going to. And when he left, he set off a smoke bomb in the studio. And when the smoke cleared, he was gone. So that was his goodbye from Houston. And I remembered laughing about that. I'm sure you're going to be hearing a lot. This looks like it's going to be a great day. I am forecasting a severe fun warning. So if you don't want to have a good time, you need to leave the program now because we've got all kinds of wonderful guests lined up who are going to be speaking and telling great stories and hopefully helping you negotiate those senior years. We're trying to do the same. Scott, I'm thinking back to when we used to work together every night. And what you may not know is after you went home, when we had some real winter storm warnings and I was concerned about roads icing up and, the worst thing that could happen would be if we had snow or ice overnight and the morning meteorologist wouldn't be able to make it in. That was my big fear. And so there were times when I spent the night at the station. I would take a sleeping bag and a pillow and a change of clothes. And here's the part you may not know. I would sneak into the sports office, which was dark. I couldn't go.
Well, David, sharing that story with us twice, but now I mean, after all these years, I had no idea. Decades ago, he's talking about when I'd go home at night after the 10 o'clock news, he'd stay there in case the morning meteorologist couldn't get in. I used to find, occasionally during bad, inclement nights with lots of snow, I'd find a pair of socks under my desk. Now I know whose socks they were. How about that? David Finfrock, after all these years, you character, but a dear friend, good man, David Finfrock. Now let's talk about celebrities. What do you say? Click here and see their photos, okay? Click here to see Ruth Buzzi talking about laughing stories. Remember Ruth? And the Dean Martin roast, Bob Tolman talking about the world's great rodeos. That's right. Drew Pearson, Mr. Hail Mary, the original number 88, who caught Roger Staubach's Hail Mary pass. Do you believe it or not? It was 45 years ago this year that happened. December 28th, 1975. One of my favorite plays ever. Do you remember that one?
I do. I saw that game too? In my living room.
Yeah.
And will never, miss that catch. After all, the Cowboys, they went to the Super Bowl that year.
You're right. You're absolutely good for you. How about that? I didn't know you were that big a sports fan. You're absolutely right. They sure did. Well, here's something interesting, weather stories. You talk about another iconic man. How about Troy Dungan, folks? Learn about Texas gardening and horticulture from the authority. Yes, the authority. Neil Sperry and Bobby Wygant. She was at Channel 5 when the station opened in 1948. Think about that, folks. 1948. Bobby Wygant's going to tell us about interviewing Hollywood stars, and her favorite of all time was Bob Hope. She also liked John Wayne, and how about some guys, they came out 60 years ago this year, 1960. The Foursome, remember that? The Beatles. That's right, all that and more coming up.
Hey, while Jerry Reynolds talks about senior-friendly cars and how to maintain your car safely, we've got David Finfrock. He'll tell us again about predicting the weather and his favorite weatherman, Harold Taff.
Oh gosh, may he rest in peace. Good old Harold, wasn't he a character? You can use the word legend with each one of these special guests that Gary and I have talked about, because each of them has left their own mark on their respective profession.
You know, and I have another favorite legend.
Who's
Scott,
that?
And that's you.
Oh gosh.
You know, folks may not know it, but in addition to being a highly respected sports director who covered everything from World Series to Super Bowls, you earned an Emmy Award, the highest honor in TV and film, for producing a documentary.
I tell you what, I was very lucky at Channel 5 to earn several of those. But the one that I remember most is when I went to Normandy on the 70th anniversary with D-Day with my son, and we both won an Emmy with 24 World War II vets. It was above and beyond, Gary. It was really something. So that's got to be the highlight of my professional career, doing that with my son, going to Normandy with all those greatest generation rock stars from World War II. They were incredible. But enough of that, Commissioner. Let's draw some door prizes. What do you say, from here in the Commissioner's Plaza?
Yes.
You see Commissioner Ficus? And right along here with the video screen behind us, he's going to go over there. And now from time to time, you're going to see us visit live with some of our friends who have zoomed us in.
Okay. And the winner is...
Drum roll.
I know this guy. Lewis Miller from Colleyville.
How about that?
Former retired dentist. All right. Lewis is going to win a dining gift card, and he can use it at a number of places. Cheesecake Factory, Red Lobster, Buffalo Wild Wings, or Cracker Barrel. $25. Lewis, we'll get back to you.
Very cool. Now, remember that we have our virtual expo.
And we're going to draw another one?
Yeah. You want to do another one?
Okay, one more. And the winner is Martha Mabry from Fort Worth. Let me give you that. And Martha is going to win an Amazon gift card for $25 that was donated by the McGee Law Firm. Thank you. Any more?
You want to do some more? We can do some more.
We'll do one more.
Okay.
And the winner is James Lutkenhaus from Bedford. And James wins a Neil Sperry gardening book from Neil Sperry, and it is autographed. And we'll get in contact with you and make that happen. So thank you and thank Neil. Okay. Thank you.
Very good. Very good. And I'll tell you what, Gary, I'll let you pick it up and tell the folks about what we've got coming up here.
Well, remember that we have our virtual expo hall where you can find all kinds of information from senior-focused products and service. You can access that area starting at noon.
And of course, Gary and I always want you to remember, be a part of our special team. Please support our sponsors, because this event takes a lot of time and resources, and if it weren't for them, we wouldn't be here. Our sponsors are making this available, so please support all of our sponsors and all of our exhibitors. Without their generous support, you would not be really enjoying this presentation today. So thank you, thank you, thank you.
Well, let's have some more fun. One of our most popular events ever is Neil Sperry, the Texas guru of gardening and horticulture.
I guess you know that Neil is a prolific writer as well, Gary. And he's written a book now in its fourth printing. How about that? It's called Lone Star Gardening. No wonder where he came up with that title, Lone Star. I like that. Now, as a special offer, he's lowering the price for today only. All right? It's usually $34.95, but today it's $29.95. And that includes a personal handwritten note to tell you from Neil, and he'll mail it right to you. That's pretty good stuff. And I didn't just see a couple of copies of Lone Star Gardening on the door prize table, did I? We're going to be giving those away.
We have a number of them, absolutely.
Going to be giving those away a little later on, so that's great news as well.
Okay, we are so glad to have Neil as one of our special guests. He's an expert that you'll be able to tune in and watch a little later on Neil Sperry's presentation is sponsored by Forest Ridge Funeral Home.
Good morning and welcome. We are so glad to have you joining Empowering Seniors. I'm Neil Sperry. I hope you've heard me on the radio. I've been on the radio for a good while, and I've actually been at this event in a couple of different venues two other times. This is a really different venue, and it's going to be fun. I brought PowerPoint today, and I'm going to share some photographs and some discussion points with you. I'm going to have a lot of fun, I think. I hope you'll have a lot of fun as well. And so we're going to turn fiction into facts for
Gary,
the next half hour or so. So get comfortable and get a soft drink or a cup of coffee, and let's talk gardening. This is going to be a beautiful weekend for gardening in North Central Texas, and it's the best time of the year. This is why we put up with all that mess in the summertime, so that we can garden in the fall. It's the best time for planting. Nurseries are stocked right now, and they're trying to clear out a lot of merchandise before Christmas. They have more time now than they do in the spring. It's cool. This will be a cool weekend, beautiful weather. Oh my goodness gracious. Let's go shopping. Let's get out in the landscape and garden. So I think I'm ready to go, and we're going to give it a try. I haven't done a lot of talks this way. I've done a few. If I make a glitch or two here or there, we're friends, right? We're going to get along just fine. So I'm going to share my screen now with you, and then I will get my talk underway, and we'll see how it goes. Hit share right there, and we'll hit share right there, and we'll see if that's working. How's that look, team? Looking all right? There we go. I think we're good. So,
Susan,
that's just...
Nauman from Grapevine. That's N-A-U-M-A-N-N. Susan from Grapevine, and Susan has won... free ear cleaning and hearing exam from Love to Hear Again Audiology. It's got a $225 value, and we want to thank Love to Hear Again Audiology for donating this gift. And that's Susan Nauman and from Grapevine. Thank you. Okay. Our next winner is, let me dig in here deep. Geraldine Lewis from Haltom City. That's G-E-A-R-L-D-I-N-E. And she will be winning a wood wall hanging called Family, which is inside of that bag. And that's a $20 value. And it was donated by WellMed Medical Management. Thank you. And we have another one. And this one is Kenneth Knight from North Richland Hills. And Kenneth is going to win the Bobby Wygant book. And we want to thank Bobby for donating that, and congratulations to Kenneth for winning the Bobby Wygant book. And our next winner will be Chester Klein, and that's K-L-Y-N from Bedford, Texas. And Chester will win a one-hour financial consulting from Financial and Estate Planning Services of Grapevine. And again, I want to thank Financial and Planning and Estate Planning Services for donating this gift. And Chester Klein has won that. Thank you.
All right, welcome back, Gary. And I want all of you to please remember that everything you need for watching Empowering Seniors 2020 is right here at empoweringseniors.com. We will have a bingo a little later on, and we'll give you the details on all of that and how you can be involved. But for now, stay right with us, right here, because with so many people watching this morning, it's not uncommon for your computer to possibly go down. I guess they call it crash, hopefully not permanently. But if it does, just hit the refresh button or even change your browser. If you have any questions whatsoever, our tech team is available with the question box, or you can simply call us at 817-248-6295. Again, that's 817-248-6295.
Well, plus, two of our lucky door prize winners will each receive an autographed copy of Neil Sperry's book, Long Star Gardening. And speaking of people we love to hang around with, here is Troy Dungan, the iconic weatherman and Care and Care member. Troy, you have been a popular celebrity at Empowering Seniors for several years. If you would, tell us about your partnership with Care and Care.
Now they tell me that they're in the process of getting Troy right now. I think he's out eating some of that good food that they brought to us here, huh?
Well, I think so. And you know, Troy cooks too. He's done a cooking show for us here at Empowering Seniors.
You know, I remember that.
You're going to be able to watch it.
Well, that's
after I think after a little later, we're going to be able to watch. And he was telling me that he filmed it.
Right.
And he did this a few days ago. And he's been eating it the last nights.
He's probably got food for sunny days. He's got food for rainy days. When it's a big thunderstorm, he's got a particular item that and a fine wine if it's a beautiful morning or whatever it might be. I'm sure he's got a little something for every particular weather forecast you could possibly conceive.
Well, he's an inspiring gentleman. I know that he has been with us, I think, this is his fifth year.
Is it? Okay.
To be with us here at Empowering Seniors. And he's always got his bow tie on.
Well, and I'll tell you what, Gary, as you heard David Finfrock say a few minutes ago, David and I worked together for decades. And, of course, you talk about somebody like Troy. He was our competition. You know, he was over at the other station,
right,
as they say.
Right.
But you still had such great respect for the man.
Because
he was just such a good guy. And you get to see that now that he's coming out here and being a part of the Empowering Seniors. So we thank Troy for, even though he's competition, he's just become iconic in this community. So it's really great to always see
him. We're so glad to have him with us here today.
Really,
and
he'll be here. Oh, hey.
There's Troy.
The devil.
Hey.
Hey,
here.
What's going on here?
How you doing?
I'm good.
Here, why don't you sit down right here. Sit down right there. You sit down right there.
Okay, thank you.
You're very welcome.
We've been telling them about Troy, about you doing a little cooking.
Yeah, your ears must have been ringing, Troy. We were saying nice things, believe it or not.
All right.
Lots of good stuff.
Give me the microphone. There we go. Thank you.
And before you say anything, I've got to tell you, the check shirt with a striped black and white tie, that is very chic.
Hey,
very well done.
Very kind, my friend. You're a fan.
Well,
very.
Check out the socks.
Look at, yeah. Can you get a shot of those socks? This is not black and white TV anymore. This is what it used to be like. This is what Troy's,
when I started.
Before color.
David Finfrock, our buddy, can't believe he pulled out that story about watching me when he was a little kid.
Well, I didn't know you were in Houston, and then you went to Detroit. Is that right?
He grew up in Houston. That's where I was at the time.
Unbelievable.
The first time I met David was at Harold Taft's funeral, and he said, I know you said you watched Harold when you were a little kid. I watched you when I was a little kid. Boom, boom. Rimshot.
Isn't that something?
Good to be with you. David, by the way, is a really nice fellow, as is Scott. Gary, nice to see you.
Hey, good seeing you.
You got a lot of sponsors today, and we want to thank all of those. But as you mentioned, Care & Care is the presenting sponsor, and not only am I a commercial spokesman for Care & Care, you know, Nolan Ryan and I have worked with them for years, and believe me, we don't sell anything in which we do not believe. Care & Care is a wonderful company. Medicare can be so confusing. If you call Care & Care and find out what you need to know, you will know what you need to know. So please, if you're about to get on Medicare, if you're thinking about maybe changing, please give Care & Care a call. If you do join, you'll have a personal concierge, and you will always be able to get them. I'll give you one quick story. In 2019, they added hearing aids to our coverage. I've worn hearing aids for 15 years. It was time for new ones. Hearing aids can be about $7,000 a pair. I got some great ones right here, and I can hear everything you're saying. With Care & Care, it costs $2,000 for both ears. Care & Care is a wonderful company. Okay, that's my commercial pitch, but again, I don't sell stuff I don't believe in. Now, why have I got this apron? Well, in a few moments, you're going to find out. Cooking in Troy's Kitchen with Chef Henry Goodrich. Guys, wow. Thank you very much. God bless. I'll see you later.
Hey, Troy, thank you.
Thank you,
and
Troy,
we will
so much.
See you later.
I'll be back.
Thank you.
Great to see you, Troy. Thanks again so much. That's good. He just really one of the nice guys.
Oh, I know.
That's
I
great.
Know. He's and, a great guy.
You know, and he's always talking about. And I saw Nolan Ryan was doing about this Care & Cares. And I always, you know, we'll have to learn a little more about that. You know,
yeah.
Just that's interesting. That's interesting.
Yeah.
Well, I tell you what, Commissioner, I hear a rumor that we actually begin bingo.
Yeah. Bingo.
Is that right?
Later on
bingo?
Today.
Oh my gosh, that's too cool.
Sometime I think around noontime.
Is it okay? Well, I've got to confess.
When we go off here, and we're going to start bingo.
Awesome. But I've got to confess to you that so many of our early registrants expressed their love for bingo that we're going to let them play. Apparently, they played yesterday. Was that
they
how it worked?
Yesterday.
Okay, they did.
Yes.
Do we have a clip of that? I'm told that we have a clip.
We very possibly do have a clip of that. And
so we're going to be playing bingo in a short time?
But I walked through the bingo room while they were doing this.
Right.
And we are so fortunate that we have an organization in Tarrant County. They serve pretty much all over, but they're based in Northwestern Hills, and it's called Community Enrichment Center, CEC.
Okay.
Randy Clinton.
I know Randy Clinton. Sure.
And Randy and Ronnie Parrish are our bingo experts.
Well, that's fantastic.
And they have been doing the bingo for us and empowering seniors for 10 years. And they just do a marvelous job.
Well, that's fantastic.
And have a great time doing it. And the people that are involved. We had so many people want to do bingo that we started yesterday. And we did two rounds of bingo yesterday. So, and we gave out prizes.
Right.
And, so it worked out
real
well. I did not play. Oh, okay. I was in the room part of the time, and we would go on air and talk to some of the players, and it was a lot of fun.
Well, I tell you what, I don't know that there's a senior around that doesn't like bingo, but I do know this. One of the most important issues to seniors is their financial security and safety. So let's look right now in on a segment of how to prevent elder fraud from our Tarrant County Criminal District Attorney's Office. Sharon Wilson's doing a great job there, so thank you, Sharon, for this video. Much appreciated.
Thank you for joining our Cigna Medicare presentation today. While we hope it answers most of your questions regarding Medicare, we're here to help you through the process afterwards. Shortly after this presentation, we'll provide a phone number to call us. Our knowledgeable Cigna Medicare representatives are standing by to help you. Sit back, relax, and enjoy the presentation. At Cigna, we believe age is just a number. And you're much more than that. You're the sum of your accomplishments, your hopes, and dreams. So it's important to choose a Medicare plan that helps you to be your best, body and mind. We know that Medicare can be confusing, but we're here to guide you every step of the way. Today, we'll go over the different parts of Medicare, explore your options, discuss eligibility, review the benefits of Cigna Medicare Advantage, compare HMOs and PPOs, and much more. You're the heart of everything we do at Cigna. It's no surprise that 4 out of 5 customers recommend us to family and friends. As one of the largest healthcare companies providing Medicare, our focus is your health and well-being.
And all of us know it's changed our lives. Mm-hmm. And certainly, probably more than anybody, it's changed the lives, especially for seniors. I want to thank our friends at NBC5, KXAS, and how well they continue to cover our news.
And of course, the weather as well. How important is that here in the great state of Texas, and certainly in the North Texas area? We certainly appreciate them making Bobby Wygant and David Finfrock available for all of us to enjoy today. Well, that's my good friend, Nader Ruddick, in action. How about that? And speaking of NBC5, did you know their entertainment reporter, Bobby Wygant, has worked for the station since the day it opened? Remember I mentioned this earlier in the program? Specifically, September 27th of 1948. Where were you?
I wasn't born.
Weren't born, I know. Thank you. So this past Sunday was its 72nd anniversary. I might add, it was the first television station in the entire Southwest. How about that? And Bobby, fresh out of college at the time, was one of their first employees. The station was known then as WBAT-TV. That's right, just like the radio station. And it was the first TV station in the state of Texas. I had the honor of being the sports director there for close to 23 years. So it's my total privilege, certainly, and honor to introduce to you this brief segment from Bobby Wygant. And it's sponsored by?
Well, Scott, it's sponsored by one of my favorite companies, Murray Media. Heck, that's you.
How about that?
I like to say I was Vanna White before there was a Vanna White. In 1960, they started a daytime program called Dateline, and I became the hostess of that program. And we did a little bit of everything. As I always said, if it isn't illegal or immoral, we'll do it. I was the producer of the show. Any writing that had to be done, whatever had to be done concerning that show, I was doing it. But it was wonderful. I thoroughly enjoyed it. The film companies started sending out stars to promote movies because they found that TV was really effective in selling movies. So that's how I started building up this backlog of interviewing stars. My favorite celebrity interview was Bob Hope, but then I interviewed Bob so many times. He used to say, Bobby, you have enough stuff on me to do a 52-week series. But the first time I interviewed Bob, of course, I was very, very excited. I was a big Bob Hope fan from the word go. We were at the SMU Coliseum, and we were sitting on the edge of the stage during one of the breaks. And he was trying to get my name straight, and he was confused because Phil was there as promotion director. And I said, Bob, my last name is Wygant. That is my married name and my professional name. I said, nobody would choose Wygant for a professional name otherwise. And he said, that's all right, honey. He said, if I can make it with this nose, you can make it with that name.
Well, Scott, two of our door prizes today will be autographed copies of Bobby Wygant's book, Talking to the Stars. Now remember, folks, starting at 12 noon, you can click on the Bobby Wygant button under Special Guest and watch this entire interview. It's very, very inspiring. And speaking of Channel 5, Scott, isn't it true that you were named Sportscaster of the Year 17 times in your almost 25 years there? That's quite an honor.
Well, there were lots of organizations, from Emmys right on down. But you always have to remember, Gary, it's all about team. It's just like a football team, a basketball team. It takes everybody coming together to make it what it was. And we certainly enjoy the awards we received. But again, it wasn't just me. It was a wonderful team that we assembled over there at NBC5. And I'm most humbled that to have been honored like that. And of course, the one that I said that was really special was the one I eventually won with my son when we went to Normandy.
Thank you for joining our Cigna Medicare.
Oops.
Go ahead.
And we're all humbled, though, that Karen Care Insurance is the presenting sponsor of the Empowering Seniors 2020, the virtual event. So right now, it's let's see, what time have we got?
It's about 10:45.
10:45? Okay. So let's check in on the progress of the Ask the Doctor panel. Our moderator is Vinny, and he'll be interviewing physicians from Texas Health Resources, Harris Hospital HEB, JPS Health System, and Baylor Scott & White. So let's look in on how they're all doing.
Scott, they took a survey of all of our participants this past year. And you know, the number one popular item was Ask the Doctor. So we've been very, very fortunate to bring it back with two separate panels this year. Cigna Insurance is one of our major sponsors. And I think we had their commercial play here a little while ago.
Okay.
And right now it's time to bring one of our other special guests. She may have played a doctor or nurse on Laugh-In at some time. And she's one of my all-time favorites. I remember walking in the girls' dorm when I was a freshman in college and seeing this show on television about 7 o'clock one evening and just thinking, what in the world is this?
Gary, that's too much information.
That was Ruth Buzzy.
You're in the girls' dorm when you were a freshman in college.
Well, I was in the area where
guys could be.
So, and there was Ruth Buzzy on television. So I still remember her on those hilarious Dean Martin roast and TV specials. So let's check in with Ruth for a taste of her full segment presented by Karen Care Insurance.
Hello, I'm Ruth Buzzy. You might remember me from Rowan and Martin's Laughing, the Dean Martin Roast, Sonny and Cher, Donnie and Marie, the Carol Burnett Show, and hundreds of other TV shows and movies over the years. I turned 84 in July. Being this age is probably easier for me because I've been playing an old lady since I was in my 30s, beginning with my famous character Gladys, who beat up Artie Johnson, plus a lot of other famous people, including Muhammad Ali with her purse. Oh, I was very fortunate to work during what I would consider the golden age of entertainment. I did shows with Bob Hope, Red Skelton, John Wayne, Lucille Ball, Jim Nabors, Dom DeLuise, Johnny Carson, Ringo Starr, and just about everyone I ever hoped to meet. People we all considered legends. Dom DeLuise was my first comedy partner on television years before Laughing, doing a crazy magic act. He played a magician, and I was his bumbling sidekick, Shakuntala. After that, I was in a big Broadway musical called Sweet Charity, directed by Bob Fosse, and starring his beautiful wife, Gwen Verdon. I would have been satisfied with that as the pinnacle of my career because it was so wonderful being on Broadway after performing in little clubs and working my way up. Oh. But the biggest surprise of all was when I was suddenly hired for Rowan and Martin's Laughing. I had to get out of my Broadway contract and move to Hollywood in 1967. I bought a beautiful split-level Spanish-style house on a wooded acre in the Hollywood Hills for $67,000. Which was a huge amount of money for a house in 1967. Nowadays, in the Hollywood Hills, that wouldn't even remodel a bathroom. Oh, dear.
$10,000 to remodel a bathroom. How about that, Gary?
Yeah, I'm telling you. And did you know that Ruth and her husband, Kent Perkins, live right here in the Fort Worth area, southwest of town? They are two of our community's true treasures.
Yeah, that Ruth Buzzy and Laughing and that whole bunch. Oh, boy, I tell you, that was something else. And here she is in the great state of Texas. Huh? That's neat, Gary. Well, here's a fun group that I've enjoyed watching. Taps and Tunes, a group of ladies, most of the seniors, that, they got some high energy, I guess is the best way to put it, that perform dance routines for nursing homes, senior citizen centers, and more senior-related audiences, just like Empowering Seniors. So I think we're going to have a clip on that right now. Let's check it out.
I think that clip, it hasn't come in yet, but we're going to have it.
We'll put it on the website,
put it
as
up,
they say.
And we'll have it.
Good.
And
all right.
So.
So we'll simply say welcome back, our friends. And remember that in addition, believe it or not, to this live show that you're seeing right now, we have over 30 video segments for you to choose from. And they'll be on the website for the next 12 months. That's right, till next year's Empowering Seniors, which we hope will be live as it normally has been in years past. So over the next 12 months, you can watch them and send the video links to your friends and your family and just have a great time and laugh and laugh and laugh and enjoy. Right, Gary?
That's that. Absolutely. And remember now to register for our grand prize drawing. And our exhibitor expo hall features a scavenger hunt. Collect the letters and spell out the words, and you could win a $500 shopping spree. Next up, let's check in with one of our medical workshops. Here we have Brenda Whitley, who is manager of community outreach from Texas Health Resources Hospital, HEB. And Brenda is interviewing a panel of their physicians. So, do we have that video? Here we go.
Hello, I'm Brenda Whitley, Community Relations Manager at Texas Health, Harris Methodist Hospital, Hearst Euless, Bedford. Welcome to our physician panel on the neuroscience services offered at Texas Health HEB. Let me introduce our panelists to you. Dr. Stephen Hurlbutt, with Neurology Specialists of North Texas. Dr. Rob Ruska, neurosurgeon with North Texas Neurosurgical and Spine Center. And Tim Katera, Director of Rehabilitation Services here at Texas Health HEB. Dr. Hurlbutt, let's start things off by describing the kind of services Texas Health HEB offers to help diagnose and treat neurological conditions.
So HEB offers a variety of things. We've had for several decades now full service neurology care. So we've been able to take care of stroke patients, epilepsy, any type of complication of MS or dementia. We've not been able to take care of some of the neurosurgical issues up until now, which is a new development for us. But we're able to handle the majority of neurologic conditions that would bring people to a hospital.
So what kind of conditions do you typically see?
Well, we see a lot of at the hospital. We see a lot of stroke. So patients who either are worried that they've had a stroke, they have symptoms of weakness or difficulty talking, something that makes them worry they've had a stroke and brings them to the emergency room. We see a lot of that. We see a lot of people that have complications of some type of issue, like back pain, weakness in the legs or arms. We also sometimes see people who are having complications of chronic neurologic things like Parkinson's or Alzheimer's. We also see MS patients who are having a flare-up of their condition.
So what treatments do we have available for those kinds of conditions?
So for those, most of those things are treatment that we really have trouble doing quickly in the outpatient setting. We're in the hospital, we can do them quickly. So a lot of it is diagnostic test that we can get done quickly, so like MRIs, ultrasounds of the neck and heart, different type of x-rays of the body that that technically could be set up as an outpatient, but would take us usually several days or weeks to get everything organized. In the hospital, we can get everything done usually within a day. And then we can come up with a plan, and the treatment plan can get started here in the hospital. So if it's medication, especially if it's medicine that requires an IV, we can get that started right away. And then we just come up with our plan, and then the plan is continued usually as an outpatient.
So generally, when a person has a condition or a problem, they will go to their primary care physician first. What role does that PCP play with overall neurological care in their diagnosis and their subsequent treatment?
Primary care is kind of usually where it all starts. Usually the patient already has a relationship with the primary care. They either have a symptom or a problem that's been slowly getting worse that the primary care is aware of, and they've been monitoring it, and then it reaches kind of a tipping point where they feel like they need to seek out neurologic care. The issue has reached a place. So if it's weakness or headaches or a symptom related to their underlying condition, like their Parkinson's, and the primary just feels like they aren't able to manage that properly anymore. And then a lot of that doesn't require inpatient treatment. That a lot of times the primary care then is referring the person to the neurologist or the neurosurgeon for the treatment that they need. Sometimes it's an acute thing. You know, they call their primary care because they have weakness on one side and they're worried about a stroke, or they have some type of acute issue that makes them unsafe at home. And usually then the primary will send them to the hospital, and then that way they can get the testing that they need that we mentioned. We can start on the therapy, you know, so if it's the physical or occupational therapy, whatever it is that they need then to kind of try to get better quicker. But the primary care usually kind of helps the patient decide. Usually the patient calls, I have this issue, and it's usually the primary care that's making the decision. Come into the office, let's see you, or you need to go to the hospital.
So Dr. Ruska, we have neurosurgeons, we have neurologists.
Okay, I believe we're ready to do some more drawings. Our next winner is going to be Julie Lopez Gomez from Euless, Texas. And Julie has won a Target gift card for $25. I want to thank Target. Thank you. And our next winner will be Judy Stanford from the city of Hearst. And what has Judy won? She has won a coat of many colors gift card for $50. Thank you. And that was donated by Mission Central, by the way. We have our winner is Carol Stacy from Benbrook, Texas. And Carol has won a Kroger gift card for $20. And the donor is Social Transportation for Seniors, STS, out of North Richland Hills. And the next winner is Susan Steinsick. And Susan is from the city of Hearst. And Susan has won preparations for one simple will and auxiliary documents for a statutory durable power of attorney, a medical power of attorney, and a physician's directive, a value of $600. And this is from the law office of Kathy Rue. Thank you. And the last one will be to Linda Steinslutz. And Linda wins a Kroger gift card of $20. And again, that's from Social Transportation for Seniors, STS. Thank you.
Well done, my friend.
Thank you.
Lots of winners today. That's good
stuff. There is lots of winners.
That's great.
Well, Scott, our hospital partners have been with us from the very first event in 2009. So we're grateful to each of them for making Empowering Seniors such a special event.
Yeah, JPS Health Network, Texas Health Harris, Methodist HEB, Baylor Scott and White, Grapevine, and UNT Health Science Center.
And here's my own staff that's here with us today, and we are going to have Rebecca Barksdale, Devin Sanders, I'm sorry, Teresa Parsons.
All those D-Long, names choke you up, huh?
Frida Landerholm, Richard Schiller, and Rosalie Kirk. And I want to thank all of them and our team. I also want to thank the Internet Imaging for producing this morning's event. And more importantly, I want to thank Fletcher Consulting for putting all this together. I don't know what his title would be, but he's just done it all. And we want to thank Fletcher and his group for the great job they've done.
Yep, year after year. Well, now also, Gary, let's remind folks they have just a few more minutes to submit questions for our Ask the Doctor panel. Just type your question in the question box right here. All right?
Yes.
Okay, you got it? And we thank our friends from Baylor, Scott and White. The Ask the Doctor was actually their idea. How about that? So thank you much. Next up here on Empowering Seniors, here's an excerpt from our Social Security workshop. Oh, they tell me that's going to be a little later, so stand by for that, Gary.
And we've got another bingo segment that'll be starting later on today at 12, and we have a clip of the session that was pre-recorded yesterday, and that'll be later on today, but our live bingo sessions today are at 12:30, 1:15, and 2 o'clock. So let's say a quick hello to our bingo caller, Ronnie Parrish from CEC. And everybody be thinking about Ronnie when you're in the bingo parlor. So Ronnie does a great job with CEC and has been doing our bingo for 10 years. And I can't tell you how much we appreciate all the work he does, and also Randy Clinton. So it's just, our people just really, our seniors love the bingo, and they have really enjoyed that, and that's one of the highlights every year is playing bingo.
You know, one of the things, Gary, that, you know, this whole concept was your idea years ago, which I think is great, but seniors enjoy things like this. They like to get together. They like to come together as a team, as a group, and try and make it better and in life a little more enjoyable for everybody around them, not just themselves. And it's that esprit de corps, feeling of helping your fellow man is so wonderful.
It really is. And Scott, one of the biggest issues with seniors is something we call senior isolation.
Mm-hmm.
And empowering seniors, and our initial goal when we started this 12 years ago was to help work with seniors and prevent senior isolation.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Seniors had a number of issues that came up when we first started this, and senior isolation was a huge, huge event. Transportation. How do they get, when they no longer can drive, how do they get to their doctor's appointment, go pick up
places their they really need to go?
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
Go to their banks.
Yep.
Even social issues where they want to go grocery shopping or they want to go to be around other seniors at a senior center. So we started working with seniors back in 2009 and working with them and have provided funding for transportation, provided funding for food, provided funding to prevent things like senior isolation. And it all kind of works together. When you know somebody's going to come by your house to either bring you your lunch or pick you up, that's a contact.
Absolutely.
That's an extremely important contact that seniors really appreciate.
Yep.
And we've been so fortunate to be able to provide that here in Precinct 3.
And how about this year? It's gotten even worse. And we've all gotten a chance to see what probably seniors have to endure on a pretty regular basis when it's not 2020 and there isn't a pandemic.
Right.
That's what it's like for them.
This has been so tough.
Yeah.
On the senior population,
right.
and they're the most vulnerable. So, we're doing everything we can. The COVID issue in Tarrant County, our main focus has been you know, working to get the numbers down, working, and that's all, so much of that's focused toward the senior citizen and those that are over 60.
Well, my mother lives in a senior living facility, and there are times that I can't go in and see her.
Exactly.
I have to be outside and in the bushes through the window.
Talking because on the phone.
That's exactly right. You can't go in.
Talking on the phone.
Yeah, it's just the whole dynamics have changed, and it's so tough. And she, you know, is not sure. Well, come on in. Come on in. Mm-hmm. Well, we've got this virus out here.
Yeah. Yeah. The whole event throughout the years has really contributed to that. We've got a guy that has been with us, I think, the entire time, a guy named Ken Nelson. And Ken has got a band, and he's kind of a one-man band. And Ken is a great entertainer, and the seniors love him. Ken and his brother have just done a great job in working with us and have just, you know, they are so loved by most of our seniors. And do we have a
video? Isn't he the Frank Sinatra tribute artist?
Yes.
Right.
He is the Frank Sinatra guy. And so if we have that, do we want to go ahead and play that now? Ken's great. Well, he's going to return in a bit later with a song he wrote and produced especially for us during the pandemic. It's called COVID, Leave Me Alone.
That's a good one. I love that. Well, seniors always want to know something about buying and taking care of their cars. That's right. Getting from point A to point B. And we are most fortunate to have the man they call the Car Pro, nationally syndicated radio host, our good friend Jerry Reynolds. That's right. His segment is sponsored by Sam Pack's 5-Star Ford. Take it away, Jerry.
The nicest that are out there. At my website, carprousa.com, I've got a list of dealerships that I recommend and I send my listeners to, and they get special pricing and special treatment. The premier show sponsor, first sponsor I ever had in Dallas-Fort Worth, was the 5-Star Ford family of dealerships. And that is owned by Sam and Tony Pack, and they're dear friends of mine. They've been part of my show now for 15 years, and they're one of the sponsors of Empowering Seniors. Great people to do business with, by the way. 4 locations, 1 in Carrollton, 1 in North Richland Hills, 1 in Louisville, and they just built a beautiful new place in Dallas over on George Bush Turnpike. So with that, I want to give you some tips for buying cars. Let's start with that, because every Saturday I hear from senior citizens who are thinking about making a change from a car to an SUV. And there's a lot of reasons why seniors love SUVs. They're very, very popular, but let me tell you just a few of them that can really make your life easier, okay? First is getting in and out of the car. With a lot of cars, they sit low to the ground, and you find yourself sort of falling into them and then climbing out. And that can be very hard on your legs and your back, whereas an SUV sets up a little bit higher and you can sort of slide in and slide out of it. The entrance and exit of an SUV is so much better than it is for a car. The other thing people love, especially seniors, is the visibility. You've got glass all the way around you. And because you're sitting up higher, you can see down that road a lot further, which is very helpful. In case something happens in front of you, there's a wreck or an animal runs out in front of you or whatever.
Celebrities just keep on a-coming. Stay tuned to hear from Dallas Cowboys legend number 88, Drew Pearson, who's about to be announced as an NFL Hall of Famer. Hopefully, keep our fingers crossed, that could be coming up next summer. Along with, who else is coming up, Gary?
Well, speaking of families, one of the best ways to connect is through Facebook. We want to thank Facebook for being a major sponsor and for sharing these insights on how Facebook has helped communities such as ours deal with the impact of the pandemic. I think we've got a little clip here from Facebook.
For the incredible $450,000 grant donation to Cook County School District.
We have $200,000 to award. That is a huge amount of money, and we are super thankful for Facebook.
Chamber RVA and Facebook have teamed up to create the RVA Business Relief Fund. It's providing grants to Richmond area businesses that have been impacted by COVID-19.
We are so proud to partner with the Community Foundation of Greater Huntsville to make a $100,000 donation to support their COVID-19 relief fund.
Scott, I want to tell you something about Facebook and Precinct 3. Facebook has a huge presence here in Precinct 3 in Tarrant County. They have given out close to $1 million in grants to educational organizations, schools, public schools, nonprofits throughout Tarrant County. They've made a huge impact here. They have a millions of square foot facility in Precinct 3 in northern Tarrant County out near Alliance Airport. And they have been a great, great corporate citizen, and we thank them for their sponsorship for empowering seniors.
That's so fantastic, Gary. Yeah. Yep. And you need people like that. You do. Right now, it is time for, does this sound right? Cooking with Troy? That's right. I'm talking about Troy Dungan, the iconic weatherman who joined us earlier, and Karen Care member, along with his friend, Chef Henry Goodrich. And his segment is sponsored by, of all things, you got it, Karen Care Insurance. Take it away.
Good morning, Empowering Seniors. Troy Dungan here with Chef Henry Goodrich.
Hello, everyone.
Good to see you again, my friend.
Good to see you as well.
We've worked together before, but not at my house.
No, and thank you for opening up your kitchen.
Janet and I are
doing this out here, or they already do this?
She's watching, so we got to behave. But we are going to make some one-pot spinach beef soup, correct?
Yeah, that's what we're going to do, and we're doing one pot because I don't want to do dishes.
This is 30
because
minutes?
I'd be stuck with that, I'm afraid. Janet's not going to stand still for doing the dishes after we cook.
Is it 30 minutes?
So now the deal is, all you seniors should have gotten this recipe with the packet that was mailed to you. If somehow that didn't happen, it'll be on the Empowering Seniors website. So,
well, I know the interview I did with Troy is about, I mean, with Drew Pearson is about 25, 30 minutes.
All right. But we also want to make sure that our beef is out at room temperature.
Oh, okay.
We don't want to put a cold item in our hot pot. All right, because we want that caramelization to get flavor.
Okay.
Flavor
you're doing great.
All right. But while we're doing this, what I'm going to have you do is mince this garlic.
Okay.
I was just kidding.
So I'm going to give you that little small cleaver. Smash it. And then chop it up, and then we're going to put a little pinch of salt on there just so you can get a little irritant to make it even nice and
smooth. My knife skills are not exactly my best attribute, so we have a medic standing by just in case. All
that's okay. You'll be all right. You're in safe hands. So,
and chop this up little pieces.
There you go.
And we're going to kind of...
You're doing good.
No, I'm not.
So, while you're doing that, I want to take this ground beef here, and I'm going to go ahead and put it in our pan.
Okay.
Now, that's the sound we're looking for.
Oh, yeah. That's a good sound.
Now,
talking about toys on a little one.
It stopped.
They're done. Go.
Okay. Well, here's Troy and with what he's been preparing. Troy, are they going to be bringing that in here in a moment?
Yes, sir.
All right.
Yes. Yeah, I got my good side there in that picture, right?
And you did
home. Troy's the apple of my eye, see?
Is that right?
Yeah, that's
turn around, Troy.
Janet's kitchen. We had my wife Janet was out of frame there. Kelly and Billy Blackwelder were there. John Fletcher was there. Videographer and his daughter were there. And Henry was there. The fire marshal wouldn't let anybody else in our kitchen.
I can imagine.
We had a good time doing that. And Henry is right behind me here somewhere with the finished product. We made it was a ground beef, spinach, diced tomato, Parmesan, garlic soup. And with bow tie pasta as well, of course. And it was really, really good.
Yeah.
And we have some here. We're going to show you in just a moment.
Do we get to eat some?
Well, I don't know about that. See, I'm not in charge here. You're in charge. If you want to say eat some.
Okay.
I think you're the boss. All right. Henry, where are you with that food, brother?
We're looking forward to it.
He's coming. I've been enjoying the show this morning. It's good fun being here. The only thing is it's better if we have real people, and next year we're going to do that again. I refuse to say this is the new normal.
Well,
I want to give people hugs and handshakes. Next time.
And we all do.
This is like being on TV. You can't see the audience. You know they're there, but it's much better when you're in person. All right.
Well, I tell you what, we have been looking forward to this. I think amazing that now, how much of this cooking do you do?
Well, you'll see here. We're going to see the demo here in just a minute, I think. And I was the sous chef, and that means I get to mince a little, chop a little, put in this, that, and the other.
Yeah.
But Henry is an accomplished and classically trained chef. So to have him work in our kitchen was really fun. We've done some of these things before, but always on a set. In our house, it was different. And here he is. Come on, Henry, the man with the food right here. Come on in. There you are.
Oh, Henry.
Yes.
All right.
Can you see that?
So, Chef, we had some fun.
Yes, we had lots of fun. We did. I always have fun working with Troy. And I told Troy that it was a pleasure always working in his shadow.
I said, yeah, right. I think it's the other way around.
Did he clean it up?
He did. He's a great sous chef. So he's absolutely wonderful to work with.
Which means I don't really know how to cook. But if he doesn't do it right, he'll sue me. That's I'm the sous chef. So are we going to watch this video of us preparing this food?
Yeah, let's watch
it. What do you say, Henry? Let's watch. Let's do it. All right.
Did
y'all
see it a minute ago?
They already did it.
Yeah, we did a little of it.
Good
so I think later, if anybody wants to come on and see it, they can click on it. And,
okay, good.
I want to say it's 25 minutes or so.
Was it that long? Didn't seem that long to us,
I think it is.
Really? Okay.
Yeah, but we'll have it up for anybody who wants to look at it.
Okay, good.
And are we going to try this?
I don't know. Do. You're the boss, Commissioner.
Scott?
No, Scott?
No.
He's watching his diet.
Yeah. Okay.
It's low sodium, so it's not going to hurt you.
I want to get some of that bow tie.
Mm-hmm. Now, is that good or what?
That is excellent.
So I told Chef Henry, I put a little salt in mine because I don't have a salt restricted diet. And I put a little Tabasco sauce on it, too. But then Tabasco is good on nearly anything.
I can't taste the Tabasco.
No, it's not in that. This is the virgin product right here.
Okay. Well, this tastes great. I want to thank you. I'm going to take an opportunity. You never miss an opportunity to get something to eat.
There you go. And the recipe is available, right? I think it's on the empoweringseniors.com website.
Yes, it is.
And also, all the folks that registered got a copy of this recipe in their packet.
Yes, they did.
So,
they
folks,
sure
there's
did.
No excuse for not making this yourself.
And in real life, how long does this take to typically make? 30 minutes? 20 minutes?
Probably not even that. So, we're looking at maybe 10 or 15 minutes to create this dish.
And it's a one-pot dish. So it's very easy to clean up, and as a matter of fact, now this is a fresh product you're eating today. This product that you saw us make, Henry was kind enough to leave that with Janet and me, and we have been eating on that, and there's still a little bit of it left.
Uh-huh.
But as of tonight, it'll be all gone.
It'll be all gone.
Thank you again, my friend.
Hey, thank you all.
Henry,
and,
thank you so much.
Thank you so much. It's my pleasure.
You bet.
Commissioner, always good to see you, my friend.
You too. You too.
God bless y'all. Bye-bye.
Thank you. Okay, thank you so much, Troy and Henry. We really appreciate y'all bringing that in. You know, a major issue that over a third of our families will face is having a loved one with Alzheimer's disease or dementia. Here's a brief clip from our Alzheimer's Dementia Workshop called Healthy Body, Healthy Brain. Okay. Okay, I think that clip will be available here later on today. And so, Scott, I think I'll turn it back to you.
All right, good. Thanks, Gary. Well, if you think back several years ago, oops, we're not going to do that one. Oh, hold on. They tell us we're going to hold off. And now I'm getting the cue to share something else with you. So let's talk about this. Another one of our friends who's been with us from day one, dating all the way back to 2009, JPS Health Network. And we thank Bobby Early and his team for joining us again today. One of the most important concerns for seniors is to avoid falling down so we can all stay safe. Here's a brief excerpt of the full program that you can see just a little later on.
Hello, my name is Amanda Hudson. I'm the nurse practitioner at JPS ENT department. We are grateful to be a part of the Empowering Seniors Virtual Health and Wellness Expo 2020. Today we'll be discussing ways to improve balance. Balance depends on maintenance of a complex network of multiple body systems that work together to stabilize vision, coordinate muscular response, and provide spatial awareness. Strengthen independent parts of that system to improve the whole. Ideas to do this, first visually, is to improve lighting and correct any vision deficits. Simple ideas would be to get plugins for your house to provide lighting at night. The second would be musculoskeletal improvements by daily stretching and routine strengthening activities. You can do this through Tai Chi, yoga, Pilates, swimming is great, in addition to weight-bearing activities such as walking. The third would be to maintain neurologic function. To do this, balance activity with rest, hydration, and a balanced diet. Number four, to maintain vestibular or equilibrium capacity from the ear, stay active. Ideas to do this would be dancing, hiking, gardening, or even grocery shopping. The peripheral nerves can be improved by controlling diabetes. You should also consider wearing firm and enclosed shoes. Very cushioned soles actually decrease your awareness of the ground. We would recommend avoiding soft or uneven surfaces, such as rugs or yards. Utilize sidewalks to prevent falls. If you are having near falls, please discuss this with your healthcare provider, as there is therapy available to improve your balance. If you are having falls despite the previous recommendations or therapy, please encourage your healthcare provider to consider a referral to ENT or neurology for further evaluation. We hope this helps you stay steady and have a wonderful afternoon. Thank you.
We're going to do some more drawings. And we're really glad to be here. And I want to thank our sponsors again. Felt drome and anthropology necklace.
Roger, what we said almost 60 years ago. But do you believe it was 45 years ago this year? Was it not?
Oh, the Hail Mary.
The Hail Mary. Yeah, December 28th, 1975.
Yeah, thanks, Scott,
Minnesota.
For reminding me 45 well, years. But I was 12 when I caught the pass.
But all these years later, still people look at you,
oh, my
sure,
goodness,
as the original 88, but maybe more importantly and more impactfully as the man that had the reception on that great Hail Mary pass. And that's when that term was born. Tell us about that, because a lot of announcers today say, oh, that was Doug Flutie in 84, or that was so-and-so. This goes back 45 years ago,
yes,
to 1975,
yes,
and you and Roger hook up on that, and that sent you to the Super Bowl eventually.
Yeah, it did, Super Bowl 10, and we had not made the playoffs the year before in 74. That's the only year with the Cowboys. I didn't make the playoffs,
right,
in my 11 seasons there. We finished the season at 8-6. We started at 1-4, but everybody thought going into 75 was going to be a rebuilding year. And that's when we had 12 rookies make the team. They called it the Dirty Dozen, led by Randy White and Thomas Hollywood Henderson, were the two, and they were the two first round picks, number
okay.
one. So everybody thought it'd be a rebuilding year, but we had surprised everybody and got to the wild card position. And back then, you only had one wild card team make the playoffs, and that team always had to go play the best team in the conference, and of course that was the Minnesota Vikings. So we had to go up there. And Scott, it was a
welcome everybody to Empowering Seniors, the virtual event this year. Okay. As the lead sponsor, Care & Care has asked me to come in and talk a little bit about Medicare, some of the changes, some of the expansions, and some of the lower costs that may be coming about that you'll see this year. So first of all, let's kind of talk about when to sign up for Medicare. Okay. You have a 7-month enrollment period when you turn age 65 for sign up for Medicare. So it's a 3 months before you turn 65. The month you turn 65, and 3 months after 65. Those are your 7-month enrollment period to sign up for Medicare. Now, what does that mean? When should I really sign up? It really depends on when you want your Medicare coverage to begin. Let's say my 65th birthday is in April. If I sign up in January, February, or March, my Medicare benefits will begin April the 1st. If I sign up in April, my Medicare benefits will begin on May 1st. If I use the 3 months after I turn 65, there's going to be a little bit of delay in my Medicare beginning. It depends on when I want my Medicare to begin. If I sign up in May, the month after I turn 65, my Medicare benefits will begin in June. However, if I sign up in June, my Medicare benefits won't begin until August. If I sign up in July, my Medicare benefits will begin in September. So there is a delay in when your benefits begin if you wait till the 3 months after you turn 65. So again, if I want my Medicare benefits to begin the month I turn 65, I want to sign up the 3 months beforehand. Again, so if my birthday is in April, I want to sign up in January, February, or March for an April 1st start date for Medicare. And that doesn't matter when in the month of April my birthday is. If my birthday is on April the 15th, my Medicare begins on April the 1st. The only time this is different is if you're born on the first day of the month. So if I was born on April the 1st, I would sign up for Medicare in December, January, or February, and my Medicare would begin on March the 1st, the actual month before I turn 65. So the first day of the month has a little bit of difference with the normal rules. So again, it depends on when you want to have your Medicare begin. Let's say I've turned 65, Tom, but I'm still working. So I have group coverage. Okay. If you have group coverage, you actually do not need to sign up for Medicare, technically at all. Now, there's different parts of Medicare, and you're going to hear me talk about parts. Anytime I say a part, that means it's part of the government insurance. So there's Part A, Part B, Part D, and we'll talk about Part C. So Part A covers our facility costs. Most times that's going to be your hospital. Part A comes with no additional premium. I never say it's free because Part A is paid for by payroll taxes. So we're paying every dollar we earn, we pay 1.45% payroll tax on that. And there is no cap on that. And if our employers match that with another 1.45%. If you're lucky enough to be self-employed, you get to pay the full 2.9%. So Part A is not free. It just comes at no additional premium because we've been paying for it during our working years. So Part A covers our facility-based coverages. If I have group coverage, I can go ahead and add Part A. It'll be my secondary coverage to help with facility costs. The only time you would not really want to add Part A if you're covered by group plans is if you have a high deductible health insurance plan. If I have a high deductible health insurance plan and I'm able to participate in a health savings account, an HSA account, these account money are coming pre-tax out of my paycheck, and those monies can be used for any medical expenses tax-free down the road. If I sign up for Medicare Part A and I'm eligible for an HSA account, at that point, I'm no longer eligible to contribute because Part A is not considered to be a high deductible plan. So I'm turning 65, I'm still working. I'll sign up for Part A if I do not have an HSA account. If I do have an HSA account and my employer allows me to do so, I'll delay signing up for Medicare Part A. Once I retire, once I leave my group coverage, at that point, I technically will have 8 months to sign up for Medicare Part B. Medicare Part B comes with additional premium. The premium is based on income, but not income that you're earning this year. It's income that you earned 2 years ago. See, Uncle Sam doesn't know how much money you make right now. So he knows how much you filed taxes on 2 years ago. So let's use the year 2021. So if I'm going to start my Medicare Part B in the year 2021, he looks at what was my adjustable gross income in the year 2019. If my adjusted income in 2019 was less than $174,000 as a married couple, then I'll pay the base rate. If my income as single was less than $87,000, I'll pay the base rate. Okay.
Okay. I guess that's our cue. And if we sound like we're talking a little loud, believe it or not, we are. As we endure this pandemic over the last 6-8 months, we also suddenly, in our virtuality here, have discovered we have some microphony problems. That's right, microphones. So this microphone's not working, I guess, the way it's supposed to. That one's kind of up in the air, so we're talking a little louder than normal because the microphones that are on the cameras that are shooting Gary and I is what's picking up the sound. So we want to make sure that you can hear what we have to say, and that's what we're doing. So, how are you, Gary? It's great
Thanks,
to see you
God,
over there.
I'm doing great, but you know, I want to talk a minute about Caring Care and the importance that Caring Care has had on empowering seniors.
Please.
They have been a great supporter of our efforts to help senior citizens in our particular, in Precinct 3. They have stood with us on so many things that we have tried to do for seniors to enhance their lives throughout our community. And, you know, my goal has always been to make Northeast Tarrant County the best place to live and work in the Metroplex. And you lived in Colleyville for many, many years.
Right.
I've lived here for 40 years plus. So we...
It was a great place.
My
family grew up here.
Yeah.
Right?
Oh, I know.
Yeah.
But they've been a great partner to us.
Yeah.
So I think we're about ready to move into our next deal with our second and final edition of Ask the Doctor. And you'll be able to watch this entire program starting at 12 noon. So let's go ahead and start our Ask the Doctor clip here.
Sounds good.
Thank you. Sounds like they're having a little bit of audio problem. Let's see.
That's a Zoom problem.
Can we hear from Ken Nelson?
Yeah.
Are we going to be able to do that?
Yeah, let me get that.
I think I think one of our featured entertainers is Ken Nelson with his original new song and video. So maybe we can get that.
Yeah, we could do that.
Or you and I could sing.
Well, no, I don't think that's going to work, Scott. I don't think that'll work at all. But here we go. I think Ken's coming up.
Ready to go.
Let's see if we can.
Thank you, Commissioner. It's so nice to be invited here once again for the 12th annual but first ever virtual Empowering Seniors Expo. The new normal is unlike any normal we ever knew. For these uncertain times, I revised the lyrics to the following song a few weeks after COVID began. Back in 1960, when Frank Sinatra and Nelson Riddle recorded this tune, it was a river they feared. Now it's an invisible enemy. Ladies and gentlemen, today I give you COVID. Stay away from my door.
We really appreciate all you do and everything you've been doing for empowering seniors these past years. And we always appreciate when you do something special. So thank you very much. COVID, stay away from.
Stay away from the door. Keep a social distance, a 6-foot social distance. COVID, stay away from my door. Following the CDC guidelines, wearing our masks and our gloves. We don't stand on the sidelines to protect the ones we love. We're self-quarantining. Life has got new meaning. COVID, stay away from the door. It's a panic-demic, an epic panic-demic. COVID, stay away from the door. Early mitigation disinfects the nation. COVID, stay away from my door. Shelter in placing prevents community spread. We're all doing our tracing, better off than being dead. We're in this together, hopefully not forever. COVID, stay away from the door.
We've got some more door prizes here. And our first one will be to Mrs. Muller. I think I know this lady. She didn't even put her name, her first name on here, but from Southlake, Texas. And Miss Muller has won a $15 gift certificate to Starbucks. And this has been donated by Terrence Special Events Foundation. Our next one is to Michael Moser from Hearst, and Michael has also won a $15 gift certificate to Starbucks, also from Terrence Special Events Foundation. And our last one is to Carmen Munez, and it is to Panera Bread for $15. Carmen is from Euless, and it has also been donated by Terrence Special Events Foundation. So thank you again. Bama, is that correct? Thank you.
Well done, group. And for those of you just joining us, Gary and I are talking. He's got a microphone, but I am without a microphone, and we're having some microphony problems. So we'll understand it's all part of the pandemic this year. That's what we're going to blame it on. It's COVID-19 problems with your microphone, right?
Yes.
All right. So as we move forward, in every single case thus far, the first 49 contestants to log in to get to play virtual bingo. That's what it's all about. So special thanks to Ronnie Parrish, our amazing caller from the Community Enrichment Center. Well done, well done, well done.
Okay, let's check in on the progress and ask the doctor's panel. And our moderator is Vinny Taneha. And Vinny is with Tarrant County Health Department. And we'll also have physicians from a number of hospitals, including John Peter Smith, THR Hospital,
UNT Health Sciences,
HEB, JPS, Scott and White, Grapevine, and UNT Health Science Center. And let's look in on how they're doing now.
The audio's not there. They're doing their Marcel Marceau imitations.
Okay, they're going.
Song I wrote, you might want to sing it note for note. Don't worry, be happy. In every life we have some trouble, but when you worry you make it double. Don't worry, be happy. Don't worry, be happy now. Be happy. Don't worry, be happy. Don't worry. Be happy. Don't worry, be happy. Ain't got no place to lay your head. Somebody came and took your bed. Don't worry. Be happy. The landlord say your rent is late. He may have to litigate. Don't worry. Be happy.
Look at me, I'm happy. Don't worry. Be happy. I give you my phone number.
Got word.
Okay. Are we ready now? Let's see here. We're kind of moving toward the end of our show here in a little bit. But here are some fun things to remember. Our goodie bags are available at the Northeast Tarrant County Courthouse. And that's at 645 Grapevine Highway in Hearst during our regular business hours. Our office is on the second floor. If you will visit our... I'm sorry, that's your part.
That's my part.
Sure. Let me go back to you.
No problem, Gary. No problem. I want you to visit our Exhibitor Expo Hall to learn about all of our sponsors that offer senior-focused products and services. And many of them have, well, having their own drawings, so register to win. We want everybody to win. And many of those same exhibitors are offering coupons and free items. Just check them out, okay? All you've got to do, and as soon as, I'll tell you what, you take it away.
Okay, as soon as Scott and I conclude, you can go to this screen right here and click on these buttons.
That's right. Yeah. Press here, right there, for the special guests, and see the full video clips from our celebrities who you've heard from this morning. Cooking with Troy, Ruth Buzzy from Laughing, that's right. And, of course, is now a resident of the Fort Worth area. Neil Sperry, NBC's Bobby Wygant, and David Finfrock.
keep on talking about the buttons.
Okay, also we have Bob Tallman, we have the car pro Jerry Reynolds, and of course, Dallas Cowboy legend Drew Pearson.
All you've got to do is click on this button and you'll see all kinds of workshops that teach you the latest with Medicare and Medicaid plus Social Security, how to protect yourself from scams and identity theft and so much more. So take advantage of it.
Okay, and also click here for health-related topics that include Ask the Doctor and our healthcare panels.
And of course, right here is the button for door prize winners. Every one of our door prize winner is listed here. So if you see your name, all you've got to do is email us to claim your prize. The details are on the page. It's that simple.
And right here is a special treat. It's our virtual expo area. This is where you click on individual exhibitors to learn what they have to offer. And most of them are offering door prizes. So be sure to visit each of them.
And Commissioner Ficus, we all owe you and your team an incredible virtual round of applause for making today possible. And since I'm having to yell, since I don't have a microphone, I'll give you the virtual round of applause. How's that sound? I'm happy. Let's face it,
thank
though, Gary,
you,
you really have done a great job. 2009, and here we are in 2020. Crazy as it might be with the virtuality of all this, you've done an incredible job. So congratulations. Thank you, thank you, thank you. For as I always sign off on my radio show, live your life as a go-getter, but share your life as a go-giver. And you continue to do that. So thank you, thank you, thank you. And let's face it, the easiest thing would have been to cancel this here in 2020. But you know, that is so many of our seniors are suffering from isolation, and they really needed to be a part of something like this today. So we certainly hope you enjoy it.
Well, Scott, that's our overwhelming reason to continue on. It's my understanding that from the start of COVID to now, we are the only major senior event that has taken place in North Texas. To all of you, thank you for taking the time to join us this morning. Please take the time to visit our Exhibitor Expo pages and take advantage of some of the great offers. We could not have made this possible without their generous support. And again, thank you again to my team, and a very special thanks to the producers, to our producer at Internet Imaging
Imaginary
from Waco, and a very special thank you to Scott Murray, owner of Murray Media in Dallas, and an amazing friend and MC.
All right, thank you. And we are Murray Media in both Dallas and Fort Worth, and of course live in Fort Worth, so proud of it. So now, folks, you can start clicking these buttons, watch videos, check on your door prizes, and visit your Exhibitors Expo Hall. And be sure to use your social media channels to tell your friends, your family, all of your acquaintances here in the great state of Texas about the wonderful time that you've had today. But most importantly, stay strong, stay positive, stay safe.
Okay, Empowering Seniors 2020, the virtual event. Thank y'all for watching.